for other future sellers, what would be your advice for them?
My advice for them? Give them a number.
Okay, because initially our EC, we should get the keys by December. Yeah. So I think when I engage you, it's already December. Yeah.
We're actually about to go and do some research on how to sell the house ourselves. And then it was the way that they opened up to us, and we decided to give it one last try. Yeah. So even despite our very tight timeline, we decided to give ourselves and also Felicia and Diane one last try. And eventually, it turned out to be a good decision. Yeah. And then we did manage to sell the house within one month plus. Yeah, it's a good decision. And I'm glad that we made that decision.
Yeah, I think they were both very jovial and very positive thinking. They're actually our third agent. So when they ask for exclusive, right, we actually don't really believe in exclusiveness anymore. But the way they present themselves, the way they present how they sell a house, the way they present themselves to us, like how they're able to do it and where they are marketing. And I think it gave us a lot of confidence. Yeah, that's why we decided to give them the exclusiveness. Professionally, they are a property agent, but actually underneath that agent skin, right, I think they are more like friends to us. I'm glad they actually told us so many things that made us open up ourselves to them as well.
You all really go to the extra mile, to help us. Yeah, and we are very glad that we had you. We should have met you earlier.
It's because of them that we are able to sell the house. It's because of them that we're able to make the transition to EC very smoothly. It's because of them we didn't really have to worry much about all the money, all the finance problem, all the shifting problems, and all the pre-decluttering problems. Yeah, I really appreciate their help. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, we'll pause for a while. I'm going to change a little bit of angle.
Okay.
So No.